Hi, Gerald. This is my cousin Fred from South Bay.
Hello, Fred.
Hello there.
I was telling him about your old man's rifle, but you claimed I'm a liar.
Nope.
I had 50 feet in my approach and drive 6 nails with it in less than 3 seconds.
Sure, Martin, look at it.
Well, he doesn't like anyone touching it. He says the firearm isn't any play to it.
Come on.
You can't see us. Yours in the barn.
Can't do it.
Gosh, Mark. They rode all the way up here just to see it.
Oh, forget it, Charlie. Your friend's gun shy. It's probably nothing special anyway.
Nothing special, huh? Well, you just get said to put your money where your mouth is. Friend, that ain't no way to talk to my friend.
Come in, this Paul wants to build this for him.
He has a beauty.
We'll see.
Hey, what's that ring for?
We're gonna really see about it.
Oh, come on, I know about riding.
It shows you.
Oh, my God, I'll give it to me. Hey,
what are you
doing? Yeah. This rifle's no toy, boy.
I told you 1,000.
As much as it has pleased Almighty God of His great mercy to take unto Himself the soul of our mother, we therefore commit this body to the ground, earth to earth, ashes to ashes, dust to dust.
Rocks in the open.
That's all I'm saying.
Sure. Well, I want him to step right over the spot where he was killed by your rifle.
I don't blame the rifle, Mark. It didn't trigger itself. It was an accident, son. Unless it's so rude. You twist the man's mind, we can't think straight anymore. Come on, let's go.
Uh-huh. I don't want to go home right now. Would you mind? I could ride somewhere by myself for a while.
See you, sir.
Come back to the hotel with me a little bit. Let me get some coffee.
ETV presents Spring Boys Halloween Bonanza, a full month of tricks and treats featuring me, special Spring Boys weeks with chilling goofy sounding block parties, free from scary surprises all over me, including the return of Spring Boys.
Hey, it's me!
Not so special than Spring Boys on Friday. Watch for me all October long. Go to ETV.com for all the details.
Whiskey and water, Joseph. Whiskey and water. How do we do this? Oh, I got 20 cents. All right. I'll cover this. So the mail's in. This is the hotel we opened. I can't compete with Miss Mallory's home cooking. You can usually give a couple of feet, though, for washing up the sub dishes.
I ain't no dishwasher. I don't work with no women. I got some advice for you, dear boy. Don't cry your luck when you're talking to strangers.
Shit.
Nice marsh, that's your star.
I should know that all along the line.
That's well. That's
surprising, Mike.
Been in bad time. They're kicking a hang on Tucson, busted out of jail. Last sighted, he was riding in this general direction.
Any description?
6'2". Joe Brown, 38 years old, life confession. He gunned down both deputies who had him in custody. I quoted his 10 men to join the federal posse out of the force by midnight.
That was it, Ravi.
I know, Mark. He's been hit pretty hard by this. They had room before him. All right, then.
Me? What else? I've never been on the horse in my life. I sell ladies' dresses.
Yeah, well, all right, the rest of you meet me there by midnight. Well, that sweet smells good. I'll wash my hands, I'll be right with you. I'm going to get it on here, mate. Top of the morning, we're going to fence.
The ride is any help you put things out.
But it's already, you can sit down there.
Are you eating?
I'm not eating right now.
Mark, when I ask like this, what is the problem we usually talk about?
I've got to get
there.
I'll see you
then.
Mark,
shut it over to your
arm,
please.
There's nothing to talk about, boss.
I want you to get what's bothering you off your mind.
That's what's bothering me. I can't stand to look at it anymore.
Mark, there's been times if I hadn't had that rifle, you might not have been born.
I wish I hadn't been.
I hear you say that about the life your money gave you. I know you're not yourself.
You know, son, when I was a boy, your grandpa gave me a knife. It was something I had been yearning for a long time. My mother didn't want me to have it. Anyway, I found me a choice piece of wood. And I set about carving a pipe right for my bar. I guess I got jealous and put the knife with myself. The bad crap. I just threw the knife down and just ran for home. It took a long time to stop the bleeding. But when it did stop, my father asked me where that knife was and told him I never wanted to see it again. And what he did? He told me to go out and find it. Well, I found it all right. The only thing was I couldn't pick it up. I just stood there and looked down at it. But my mom came along. She picked it up. She closed it. She put it in my hand. And then she looked at me and she said, I'm not afraid anymore, son. And you mustn't be. Don't you be afraid. Take a rifle.
No. Please, Father.
Take it.
I can't. Don't you understand, Paul? I can't. Just be near it.
Take the rifle, Mark.
No! Oh, I do like it. I'll take it.
Good.
I'll never look in one
fine. The night is well.
Good night, Mr. Ditch.
Thank you. What are you doing here? This is late. That's the last Christmas, isn't it? Thank you, Mark. There's something wrong.